द लन सॉलिसिटर जनरल देन चैलेंज्ड द ऑर्डर्स ऑफ द डिवीजन बेंच ऑफ द हाई कोर्ट ऑन द ग्राउंड ऑफ वायलेशन ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ नेचुरल जस्टिस. इट वॉज कंटेंडेड दैट वाइल द हाई कोर्ट हैड कंक्लूडेड द हियरिंग एंड रिजर्व्ड जजमेंट ऑन 20th July 2011 बाई ऑर्डर डेटेड 12th October 2011, इट डायरेक्टेड द स्पीकर टू प्लेस ऑन रिकॉर्ड द स्टेटस ऑफ द प्रोसीडिंग्स रिलेटिंग टू द डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन पिटीशंस. ऑल्दो द सेम वर ड्यूली फाइल्ड विदाउट गिविंग द पार्टीज फर्दर अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ हियरिंग विद रिगार्ड टू द सेड रिकॉर्ड्स, द डिवीजन बेंच डायरेक्टेड द मैटर टू बी लिस्टेड फॉर फर्दर कंसिडरेशन ऑन 19th December 2011. इट वॉज सबमिटेड दैट दो द बेंच did not assemble on 19th December 2011, the division bench delivered the impugned judgment on 20th December 2011 without any further opportunity of hearing to the parties. The learned Solicitor General submitted that the procedure adopted was contrary to the law laid down in another case wherein it was stated as under. In view of the limited scope of judicial review that is available on account of the finality clause in paragraph 6 and also having regard to the constitutional entendment and the status of the repository of the adjudicatory power, that is speaker, chairman, judicial review cannot be available at a stage prior to the making of a decision by the speaker, chairman, and a quick time action would not be permissible, nor would interference be permissible at an in-between stage of the proceedings. Exception will, however, have to be made in respect of cases where disqualification or suspension is imposed during the pendency of the proceedings, and such disqualification or suspension is likely to have grave, immediate, and irreversible repercussions and consequence. The learned Solicitor General sought to re-emphasize the fact that the present case is not a case involving disqualification or suspension of a member of the House by the Speaker during the pendency of the proceedings, but relates to disqualification proceedings pending before the Speaker, which were not being disposed of for one reason or the other. It was submitted that the fact that the speaker had not finalized the disqualification petitions for almost a period of 2 years could not and did not vest the High Court with power to usurp the jurisdiction of the Speaker and to pass interim orders. The learned Solicitor General lastly urged that the single most important error in the impugned judgment in that it sought to foreclose the right of the Speaker to decide the disqualification petitions under paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule. The said decision was also wrong since the division bench chose to follow judgments which related to the concept of a split under paragraph 3 of the 10th schedule, which today stands deleted therefrom. The learned Solicitor General submitted that there was a clear difference between matters relating to the erstwhile paragraph 3 of the 10th schedule and paragraph 4 thereof. While paragraph 3 of the 10th schedule required proof of two splits, paragraph 4 requires proof of only one deemed merger. The learned solicitor general submitted that there was no concept of deemed split in paragraph 3. It was submitted that paragraph 4 is meant only as a defense to a petition for disqualification, and the same would succeed or fail depending on whether there was a deemed merger or not. It was further submitted that under paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule, the speaker was not the deciding authority on whether a merger of two political parties had taken place or not. It was urged that the expression used in paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule for the purpose of paragraph 4 clearly indicates that the deeming provision is not in addition to, but for the purpose of paragraph 4, which is entirely different from the scheme of the paragraph 3, which uses the expression and thereby indicating that a split takes place only if there is a split in the original political party and at least one third of the members of the legislature party also joined in. It was further submitted that the use of the expression if and only if in paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule is to reemphasize the fact that the speaker cannot decide whether merger of the original party had taken place, as he is only required to decide whether merger was a defense in a disqualification petition filed under paragraph 6 of the 10th schedule.